Hey, it's David Duford at DavidDuford.com, where I help insurance agents like you become top producers. So today's video is an extension, a continuation of my insurance sales system ideas videos. We've done a couple so far. You've seen videos about the Turning 67 Medicare market, the $1 million baby program, and others. And then today we're going to talk specifically about how to sell insurance, specifically life insurance to business owners. This is something that I think is really good. It is a great opportunity. And it's bolstered by the fact that a lot of the top producers and the authors behind me from all the insurance books I've read have all predominantly sold the business market. I would say 95% of the authors that I've profiled have all sold to small businesses and medium small businesses. And they've been very successful. We're talking about seven-figure producers in many circumstances. So there's got to be something to it, and there's got to be a level of lucrative aspects to it, enough that it's worth getting involved in. So what I'm going to do, from the perspective of someone who's studied the greats in the insurance business that have worked the business markets, as well as conversations with those that do currently, I'm going to give you some kind of overview about how you can get involved and what it takes to sell to business owners, and kind of how you would get in front of them, how you would prospect them, what kind of products you'd want to sell, and kind of some long-term strategies as to what you could expect out of the business. So let's talk, first of all, about who exactly we're talking about, business owners. So business owners would be anybody. These would be people who have storefronts, that have employees or who are just consultants or somewhere in between. We generally don't target people in this particular category, or the ones I've talked to don't necessarily target the larger businesses, the more corporate setups. That's kind of a different market altogether. A lot of people who target small business owners are looking for a size of a business that they can walk in, and there's not a lot of issues getting to the decision maker, the check maker, the business owner himself to talk. This market is really good for a lot of different reasons. The first reason is that because of the nature of their business being their business, there's not a lot of people who have some kind of how do you say, their own insurance benefits set up. You know, they left their job if they had one before, and behind they left their health insurance, they left their life insurance, disability, other types of insurance. And while they may need a requirement for the basics of insurance to operate their business and insure their inventory and that kind of thing, a lot of that personal insurance gets kind of left behind and forgotten about. So there's a huge opportunity to go out and talk to these business owners, because a lot of the times they're so busy in their business, building it, growing it, reinvesting back into it, that they just don't stop long enough to think about their own personal insurance needs to take care of themselves and their family, as well as to protect their business too. And the great thing about this business is I thoroughly believe it is not that competitive. There's just not a lot of people like there were 20, 30 years ago, knocking on doors, visiting people, and talking to them. Case in point, I owned a final expense business. I do that too. But I owned a personal training business. It was right along a main drag. It was on the backside of a building. But, you know, any kind of enterprising person who was prospecting would have been able to find it. And I was there for 5 years. And there was not one, I was there 3 or 4 years. There was only one situation where, no, two. No, there was just one. One situation where I had somebody walking on me cold to sell me insurance. And I bought from him because I needed health insurance bad. But he just walked in and talked to me, and he got me right away. And I said, dude, I'm really busy with my personal training clients, but I need to talk to you. Would you please come back? And I bought. And nobody ever stopped by again. I did an interview with a guy named Claude Whitaker. He's a sales trainer, and he owns a vacuum store. He's had a total of, I believe, 2 life insurance agents call on him. 2. And he's in a storefront in a major area. And he bought life insurance each time for some huge premium. Nobody stops by and asks. And what I'm saying to this is that if you hear that kind of nobody stops in, but I have a need, that means if you go take advantage of this, you're going to put yourself in a position to leverage the ability to sell insurance like others won't do. So that's a good thing for you. Let's talk about that, since we're kind of briefly discussing how we get in front of business owners. There's a couple of different ways to do it. I believe, and I've learned this from many different producers, and you'll see this again in the books that you read. Most of the time it's done, initially at least, through some kind of cold calling, and then eventually manifests into referrals. But cold calling is a great way in this business to get started. And when I say cold calling, that can consist of either telemarketing yourself to set appointments to show them the kind of work that you do, or just dropping in to do the same thing. It all works fairly well. And I can tell you this, between me failing at a final expense and coming back into the business, I work for a company called Aramark. It was a uniform service division of the company. And what we would do is go into small, medium, and large businesses. And basically, it was like outsourced or managed services where, you know, their reps would have uniforms. We would wash them, clean them, supply them uniforms, take care of them for them so that the employees didn't have to do all that stuff. So their model of marketing for business was cold calls. They would hire reps in like myself, and we would just call on businesses. And I learned after about a month or two of doing this, I would go out. I was in a sales associate position, so I would prospect for the age or for the senior sales reps and just kind of feed them leads. I found it was really easy to get in front of business owners. And I think it's because business owners are all in sales to some extent. They're responsible for growing their business and being successful. And deep down, they respect the person that has the guts to walk in cold and just show them what they do. Many times business owners realize you're in business too, in a sense. And they're willing to give you 30 seconds to explain what you do, and they'll tell you honestly if it's something that makes sense or not for them. So I found it was way easier actually cold calling business owners than it was actually working purchase leads for residential and final expense, which is crazy, but it was not that bad. And a lot of people are just super nice. They're willing to talk to you. They respect you. And many of them understand being in business. They like the straight truth. They'll tell you, yes, I'm interested, or no, I'm not. And you can just move on from there. And again, couple that with the fact that none of these businesses get called on for this kind of stuff, for personal insurance or group insurance or that kind of thing. It's very powerful. Same thing for telemarketing. You could call and just set up appointments and do well that way too. You could also do things like self-generated. You can outsource it. I've heard of insurance agents outsourcing that appointment setting process where they don't telemarket it, but somebody else does. And business owners agree to meet with the agent and they just set up their days and go see people, and it works just fine too. And then also you could also use personal letters. Ben Feldman used it a lot, but he did a lot of research on his prospects first before he sent the personal letters out. Marv Feldman does as well. That's Ben's son. There's a lot of people that use some kind of personal introductory letter. Larry Schneider, who does disability insurance to business owners. I did an interview with him. He recommends a personal letter as a way to prospect, if not just going in flat out cold. So if you're kind of worried about going in cold, you can send a letter as kind of a pre-approach letter, then call behind it or show up. Personally, I think if you're just going to show up, just show up. You know, again, a lot of people think you need some kind of personal approach, but the kind of people that think that never really have called on business owners cold, and you don't need it. It's really just a crutch. Do the crutch if it'll make you do the job, but you don't really need it, and you'll find out soon enough. So those are ways you can prospect. The other way is, of course, referral generations. John Savage did this, Tony Gordon, where they make the sale, they gather a few names, and then they call on that person to do a financial consultation or just to get to know them a little bit, and then set up another appointment later to talk about financial consulting. And they move to this referral-based type of strategy as quickly as possible. Again, being in business, the great thing about targeting business owners is that they understand the best person to sell to is a referred person. So I can tell you personally, as somebody who's been in business, I love referring to people. I have an appointment setting group I work with as a business owner, and I refer all of her business to her, or a lot of it. And it makes life easier for that person, especially somebody who's done a good job. You want to share that information with people you care about. And if anybody asks me for referrals, I'll earnestly try to help them out because it makes me feel good. And I'm in business too, and I know how much it costs to generate a decent prospect. So I say all this because business owners think like me. And a lot of them will be kind to share names with you if you've done a good job of servicing and helping them out with their needs. So referrals are something you want to, of course, get to. So maybe you're wondering, okay, business is good. Business owners is a good source to target. What would I actually sell them? So there's a lot of different ways to do this. My recommendation is to pick one product to start with and then eventually start to add in more products. Because what your goal is in the business market is just to create customers, right? What you're going to do and find out is over the lifetime, you're going to sell more insurance to these business owners as they get bigger, as they grow, as they make more money. And they're going to basically go back to you because you did a good job and they like doing business with you and they're going to want to buy more. So you got to look at this as a way to get the foot in the door to create a client or create a customer, and then to develop a clientele and relationship off of all the people that you've done business with. So I like simple products that are mass marketable, that are really good for a big amount of people, and are simple to discuss and explain. So a couple of ideas that come to mind. The first would be even just basic income protection. Again, a lot of these people, a lot of these business owners don't have the time to think about this stuff, and they know they need to do it, but it just gets left behind. Go in and talk about personal income protection for the business owner, why it's important as a way to, give their family something to live on, as opposed to coming in and just taking over the business, which a lot of them don't want to do. You could also do voluntary payroll deduct as a way to set up life insurance for the employees. That's a simple product. It's very simple to interact and put together for the client, and it's a benefit to offer to the employees without the employer having to pay anything. Another idea is disability. This is what Larry Schneider does or did back when before he started recruiting agents. And nobody talks about disability these days, but a lot of these business owners need it because they don't get disability. And if they get hurt and they can't work, a lot of these are smaller companies and they're going to need some kind of income replacement because their business may not necessarily survive without them. Frank Betcher, How I Raised Myself from Failure to Success in Selling, he sold a lot of key man type policies where if you had partner A, partner B, what would happen if the one partner died and the surviving family came in and had joint ownership in the company and what implications did that have? And so that was basically using life insurance to buy out that portion of the family's ownership in the business in exchange for the death benefit and then getting a buy sell agreement funded in place. And these are very lucrative contracts, and it allows the business owners to basically continue the business continuity, without having to be in a position where now they've got to deal with a family that doesn't necessarily want the business. They want the money. They have different goals, and it can affect the business negatively. So these are great ideas, simple products to talk about, to go out there and talk to business owners about kind of the things that are important to cover, and just to go stop in and talk about them. You know, again, do your due diligence, learn more about these products, and figure out which one works best for kind of your personality type, and then lead with that and make a go out of it. Short-term, long-term strategy, again, I mentioned this earlier. When it comes to selling the business market, you really just want to make these people customers first, okay? That's why I recommend a simple product, not some extravagant product at first, especially as a new person, because you have to trust the long-term process of that. A lot of these business owners will continue to be in business. They probably don't have financial planning, and they'll utilize your services when it's needed because of the relationship and trust that you've built. So, and you'll get, again, more sales that way. You'll grow bigger accounts that way. So there's a long-term implication of the kind of income you can make by just first starting to make them a customer to begin with. Second, expand your offering and add more as they grow. Kind of covered that as well. The last thing I'll add here, it's not in my notes that I'm referring to, is I think it's really important in the business market to find a mentor, okay? So the business market can be a little bit more complex because you're dealing with larger case sizes. You're dealing with different kind of rules and regulations than in some cases just a business to residential type of market. I don't recruit business to business guys that sell to small business owners because it's not my forte. I think it's a great business model. I would probably be in it if I wasn't so heavily involved in recruiting residential agents or agents that work in the home. It's so lucrative. All the top producers go that route. There's just a lot of income in it. It's daytime work. There's so much positivity about it. Find a brokerage that teaches you how to do it. Find, even if you got to go captive, I'm not opposed to that either. A lot of the top producers are captive, like with New York Life, Mass Mutual, that kind of thing. Find an outfit that will train you on how to do this and give you the kind of coaching and training and advice that's necessary to be successful. I think that's a key thing. No matter what you sell, to have that kind of backing to you. I hope you enjoyed this video on selling to business owners as an insurance sales system idea. And if you'd like more information on how my stuff works, you can go to daviddufour.com and poke around, see what's out there. Make sure you subscribe if you like this video, and do like the video as well. And leave a comment below. My name is Dave Duford at daviddufour.com. Thanks for watching. Bye.